What's up, guys? It's the Hungry Fisherman. We are camping out at Keaau's on the west side of Oahu. Waves are kind of big right now. I'm gonna see if it kind of dies out a little bit so I can catch some bait. All I brought was a dough bait, nothing else. But you guys will see the waves, I guarantee it. All right, guys. So it's day two, I think it's around 8 a.m. I caught a small moy early this morning while everybody was sleeping, so I think I just got a picture of that one. We'll probably try and see if we can put it up in the video. But as you can see, it's kind of pumping, so it's pretty hard. Waves are just tossing my lure around. I can't catch any live bait right at the moment, and that's my fault. I don't know why, but yeah, so we might go to a different beach later on. Oh, thank you. And we'll see what we get there. All right, guys. There's Holly, she's coming in. She looks defeated. She threw her bait away.
That was your brother's idea.
What's up? You know your boy Ethan, he come, he would help me cook eggs like he was standing here.
Yeah, that's how he
is. Hey, check that one, bro.
They're having a very important meeting. All those birds. Very important.
I should be wearing my tubbies.
Yeah, go get your tubbies.
I just need paper towel. Baby.
Just keep that on for now. Okay. Did you put water on it?
Yes.
Put water on it again.
This part of the video contains graphic images. Viewer discretion is advised.
Skin.
The whole thing?
Yeah.
No, you use super glue. We use caulking. Stupid. No, serious, because we don't carry super glue. What we use super glue on the site for? Nothing.
Well, you should clean the surface area before you put the back.
Oh, this is just.
We get the paint.
You don't have to look.
Oh, no, it's okay.
Just close your eyes, look away. Let's try to get the blood off.
Open the flap.
I don't need it.
Clean it later.
No, I was talking about the toll when you're pressing on the surface.
But best
way
is to go clean it with soap and water.
Yeah. They just need a dump hydro peroxide.
Yeah, just dump your foot in that bucket. Put some soap and water on it.
If you don't clean it, you could lose your toll.
You know how many times I did that thing? I work construction.
Yeah, I know. You need to wipe your hands off because you don't want to get that. But you gotta actually.
And then
I can't at this angle.
Yeah, are we?
Can I see?
Are you gonna go back out?
I put it back in the tent.
Oh. Yeah.
To the hospital.
For you to keep later. And do you want gauze to wipe them later? My sister's a nurse practitioner and gave me all this stuff for us when we get bus up. She brought them from the mainland. Oh, look, we have matches.
Oh, set his foot on fire.
We should do that. You want us to,
cauterize it.
And look, we have an extra blade if you want us to cut the foot off. Because we need to amputate. Yeah, I was looking for hydrogen and I didn't bring hydrogen. And if you need ibuprofen to help you out here.
That's what happens when you slip on the rocks.
I have Neosporin. Do you guys have more stuff?
Okay, liquid Band-Aid.
You gotta put a shitload of stick all the way around in a huge, it's gonna hurt. So I'm telling you right now, that's gonna need to stay on for a few days and let it fall off by itself. Just don't try to pull off the liquid Band-Aid. It's gonna hurt. I used to use it when I paddle, and there's no way you can take it off without it hurting because this thing's deep. Just put it thick and then let them have that on the next few days.
Yeah.
But make them thicker and then just let it dry.
Mom would be proud.
Yeah, just let it dry. Yeah. It's not super deep though, so.
It's like that deep.
Yeah.
It's really gross.
Hello.
What happened?
I injured myself. Because I forgot to put my tobbies on, and when I slid down the rock and landed in the sand, I guess I hit a sharp stone or something inside the sand, sliced my big toe open. There's a big flap. It's like that much meat on top of it. It's all right. Cleaned it up. Everybody came rushing with their first aid, which I really appreciate. I was the center of attention. So. Remember, wear your tabis. It helps. That's twice now I get cut on the rocks. Still, it's fine. I'm gonna go back out fishing in a bit. It's not a party until somebody gets hurt.
Gross.
Oh, boy. You guys don't like blood, don't watch certain parts. There's gonna be a decent amount of it, I guess. You know, Leah. Yeah, I have a bucket over there. I gotta fill it up. Can you bring it? Oh, I'm a crab.
You caught it on your pole?
Yeah. You didn't want to let go.
Can you use it this week?
Yeah, later. I'm gonna throw them in the bucket. Jump the pole. Kupipi. Towards the tail so you don't hit any vital spots. Take a little piece of plastic that you put a hole in it, shove that over the barb, and that'll actually help keep the fish on. So whenever you got your canoe poles out or your dunking poles out, make sure that you tie them down. I got this tie down right here attached to my rope. I have another rock spike stuck in the ground, really secure, and I tied it to that. So if by chance my pole goes, this is gonna hold it, and hopefully it holds on to that so my pole gets saved and we can land a fish. Wish us luck. I wonder if it's a Puhi strike. Bell ringers, nothing big. Just gonna check bait. It's probably gone, but let's see what happens. I think it probably was an eel. Probably wrapped itself up, got stuck in a rock in the reef. And that's probably what happened. Gotta retie, recast. Oh yeah. Third day of our camping trip where everybody's packing up. It's getting really hot already, so but as you can see, I don't know if the camera gives it justice, but the waves are really big. I'm not gonna fish anymore. Took a big strike yesterday on the big pole, didn't stick, caught a small moy, bait fish. It was fun, but it was more for family, friends. For the little one and everything like that. So we'll see you guys next time. Stay hungry, guys. Okay, so real quick recap of what happened to my toe, how I sliced it up and whatever. I was fishing. Basically I broke off, so I had to go and retie my stuff. Coming down over here, foot and my slipper slipped off here and my toe hit this. As you can see, got some really sharp edges right there, over here. I don't know where over here it hit, but this is what it hit. And then I had to hop up that way. I didn't even know my foot was bleeding until I got all the way up. So make sure that when you guys go, be safe. Don't be stupid like me. Make sure you have the right footwear. It always helps.